eat treats. We take naps. We play ball all day. We have swimming pools out there that they swim in. Yeah, it's just like a regular daycare, only all my kids have four legs.
And then, I offer an in-home service, and there's lots and lots of pet sitting businesses out there. Yes, it is a real business. It is a real job. We've even got national organizations for it. If you work long office hours and you don't have time to come home and let your dog out for the bathroom in the middle of the day, then we can come in, get him some exercise, take him out during the day, get him some socialization. Really good option for puppies when they're housebreaking and stuff. And some people use a combination. They'll take their dogs to daycare some days. They'll have dog walkers come the other days. Sitters also, if you're gone on vacation, will help your house look like somebody's coming each day. They pick up your mail, they can open your blinds, turn your porch lights on, things like that. So people are less likely to break in. And if somebody does break in, they'll notice right away. So I'm Lynn from Best Trained Dogs, and everything I do in my training is positive-based training. Sit. Down. Stay. She will grab the treats, of course. Everything I do, instead of smacking them with paper or yelling at them, the reward is... that trains service dog for people with disabilities, because right now in the state of Ohio there's 1,600 dogs or people that are waiting for dogs. Socialization is really most important the first 3 to 4 months of a dog's life. Pretty much anything they don't experience in that time, they're going to be afraid of. So, a truck, a wheelchair, people a lot of times say they socialize their dog and they let the dog be around their family members, but you want to have the dog be around people that look different, people with beards, people that talk different, people in wheelchairs, crutches, and all kinds of different outdoor things the dog's going to be exposed to down the road.